far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes.
Hello, my darling little chickpeas. And I have to let you know, I am not 16 years old. So that was kind of awkward, Dad. I feel like he should remember my birthday. So sad. I'm not going to argue with him.
It's not my call.
It's not my call. Those are the rules.
You're 16 now. So this year, you take the goat.
God, I remember a lot of things. I'm here
Everyone has to take
with my brother, the voices. I don't think he'll talk. That's okay. But I'm really sick. Yeah. This didn't work for me in real life either, but that's okay.
When I started studying medicine, one of the first things I
learned was between this and the beginning of Mass Effect, this is taking so long to get to the regular game. And I'm so happy that in New Vegas, they changed the intro sequence to not be quite as obnoxiously long.
There's a reason they did that.
Take care, sweetie. I got out of here.
You mean because it was obnoxiously long?
Yeah, there's a reason for that.
Why, it is obnoxiously long?
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm moving much better today. Woo! Bobblehead! There are bobbleheads everywhere throughout this game. Not, well, yeah, this one has like 20 or something.
100,000.
You found a Vault Tech limited edition bobblehead! The inscription on the base reads, "The smart man knows a bandage only hides his wound." Your medical skill has been permanently increased by 10 points. Woohoo! Yay! Success. Open the door.
I'm glad you'll never use it.
I use my bobblehead. I think you should be able to use your bobblehead as a weapon. Hold on a second, guys. I'm not moving because I need to increase my speed.
That's a lie. He wasn't moving to insult you guys.
Jonas, leave me alone. Let's go. Alright. Have I decided to be a good person or a bad person? I'm going to be I am just going to be a terrible person. Shut up. And make sure you speak up.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hello, YouTube. That's okay. Butch.
Looks like you're having fun here.
Damn right. And you'll stay out of our way. You know what's good for
Bitch,
you.
I will teach you how to say my name.
Especially not this stuck up little
daddy's girl. Normal?
Alright. I was gonna say.
Maybe I can help.
Her way, huh? I can
I got myself a little beard and some horns. Very nice, very nice. Girl.
Hey, lard ass.
Pounds,
Amada. Hey, fatso. I got something you can put in your mouth.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
She broke her leg and gravy poured out. You're all right. Gonna go cry to your daddy, fat ass. Why would you do that?
Just leave me alone. Ah, I see all hopes of having sex with her are gone.
Well,
hot lesbian sex completely out the window for this game.
Sorry, don't worry, as a black man. Racism.
I don't really see.
You did say I couldn't make racist comments.
I don't think referring to his race is racist, but alright.
What else in fine was funny racist, Sally?
On your day. Okay, I apologize. No, normally, alright, new rule on the channel, no racist comment.
That's like half your, humor. Gone. Just gone. No longer will we have this.
Why? Yeah, I'll take the test so you guys can see it. We'll start it. I actually find it really obnoxious.
I hope the game freezes.
Suck. A dick.
Oh, okay. No racism, but totally, totally going with that gay angle. I see how we're playing this.
I finish it up. Everyone take their seats. Am I in Butch's seat?
Oh, yes.
Oh, damn it! No!
What the hell?
Alright. What the hell? Dude, you're a jerk!
That's win.
Oh, what the?
Amada can't say because of a fat ass.
Alright, going back in my seat.
What are you, a guy disguised as a girl?
No. I know. I'm sorry, guys. I didn't do well with my hairstyling. I woke up in the morning and he went, fuck this shit, and just cut it all off. Alright. Now we're going. We're going to take our goat test. He reads the questions, so I don't have to read them to you. But this takes an obnoxiously long amount of time, especially when you get to the last question. He just drones on and on, and you just want to be like, I know the answer, shut the hell up!
Allie,
God.
Quick question, was it just your hair you cut off? or your penis.
I don't...
Does it look like you cut off your penis?
I don't get it. Anyway, so the choices for question one are, but doctor, wouldn't that cause a parabolic destabilization of the fusion singularity?
Nope.
Or, yeah, up yours too, buddy. That is quite often what I say to people. Sometimes a little more graphic in detail. Anyways, say nothing, grab the nearest pipe and hit the scientist over the head to knock him out. For all you know, he was planning on blowing up the vault. I'm clearly an idiot for that one. Or say nothing but slip away before the scientist can continue his rant. I have experience with both the second and the last one.
Yes, the question is a sexual innuendo.
They're definitely up yours too, buddy. Oh, this picture bothers the living crap out of me.
Because he's naked?
No, although that's a little awkward. I don't know why he walked in and was like, "There's fungus growing on my foot. Let me strip my clothes off for you." What do you do? No, it's the fact
not
that there's...
Not just his foot, Allie. It's elsewhere.
Shut up.
Alright, I'm gonna leave now, because I'm sure Allie doesn't like my penis humor.
Alright, he's leaving. We'll continue. No, it's because there's a mushroom growing out of his foot and stuff like that creeps me out. Anyways, choices. I can amputate the foot before the infection spreads, scream for help, medicate the infected area to the best of my abilities, or restrain the patient and merely observe as the infection spreads. I am going to be a total dick in this game, so we're definitely picking the last one. Alright. Oh, I found a young boy discovered in the lower levels of a vault. I'm sure that's what the creepy Uncle Henry said when he got caught with Jimmy. Sorry, guys. Pedophilia is not funny. Alright, let's see. What do? I give the boy a hug and tell him everything will be okay. That's definitely what creepy Uncle whatever the hell I called him 30 seconds ago would do. Confiscate the stolen property by force and as punishment leave the boy there. That's kind of a dick move. Pick the boy's pocket and take the stolen item for yourself and leave him to his fate. Definitely higher on the dick scale. And leave the boy to safety and turn him over to the overseer. Screw you, I'm stealing the shit and then leaving him there. That's what you get. If you're going to steal, don't get lost. Know your way home. It's clearly obvious that you're breaking the rules, and it's really awkward when the police come up and find you, and you're like, "Oh, officer, I'm lost." What? No, officer, that is not the stolen money from the recent bank robbery in the back of my car, and that is not an open booze bottle next to me on the seat. Funny story, actually. Let's see. Hold on. Let's answer this question. I've been made things. I actually played baseball when I lived in Plymouth. It was boys and girls. There was no softball team, and I moved to Braintree, Mass. And there was a softball team for girls and a baseball team for boys. And I thought it was stupid that I'd play softball when I've been playing baseball for a couple of years. So I was the only girl, and I got hit a lot. And in my first practice, the coach's son hit me in the nose with the baseball and gave me a bloody nose. But I got right up in practice at the end of that. Anyways, let's see. I will be the catcher because that's what I was on my own team. Anyways, funny story about bank robberies. A friend of my brother's, of the bank by our house got robbed. And a friend of our brother's was riding his bike and going down. And the police pointed a gun at him and told him to stop because they thought he was a bank robber. It was pretty funny in retrospect. Probably not too funny at the point in time for him, but that's okay. So let's see. My mother needs me to kill someone, yes! Or my grandmother needs me to kill someone, yes! And my real grandmother is actually insane enough to ask this for me. So let's see what we can do. Obey your elder and kill the resident with a pistol. Bam! Offer your most prized possession for the life of the resident. It's like deal or no deal right there. Oh, chest A is the pistol? Well, if you take this deal of chest B of my favorite comic book, you can get more money. I don't know where I was going with that. Ask Granny for a minigun instead. After all, I don't want to miss or throw my tea in my granny's face. Now, that is just rude and would cause serious burns. We're killing that resident with a pistol, because I like pistols, I think. I wish I knew how to shoot a gun. Kind of, sort of. I think it would be nice to be able to do that, but I've never taken classes. Alright, so he locked himself in the bathroom. What am I going to do? Use a bobby pin and pick the locked door? Clearly, I don't carry many bobby pins since I cut my hair short. Trade the bolt hoodlum for his cherry bomb and blow the door open. That seems like there could be shrapnel injuries. Probably not. Who knows? Go to the armory, retrieve a laser pistol, and shoot the lock off. Pew, pew! And I'll walk away and let the old cot rot. Oh man, that last one is totally me. Has it all over it. Question I can seven. Take it. Oh, no. That's my favorite part. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation. It's like every self-help training manual thing you've ever had to watch. So what is my course of treatment? A bullet to the brain seems a little counterproductive. A large dose of anti-mutagen agent? Pray, maybe God will spare you in exchange for a life of pious devotion. I'll have three hands, one in the middle, two on the outside, feel like a super prayer hand, or removal of the mutated tissue with a precision laser. Wow, really? Dang. Can't really have any dick moves on this one. I'm just gonna take a whole bunch of pills. Cause that's pretty much the answer to everything in life, isn't it? Ooh, someone has something I want. What I'm gonna do.
What's the best way to obtain it?
Let's see, I can trade the comic book for one of my own valuable possessions and what, be out of valuable possession and then have a comic book? No thing. Steal the comic book at gunpoint? Seems pretty good. Sneak into the resident's quarter and steal the comic book from his desk. And I would add, rearrange his furniture so he thinks he's going crazy. So when he's like, someone stole my comic book and rearranged my furniture, people would be like, are you retarded? You probably just misplaced it if you don't remember moving your own furniture. Anyways, flip some knockout drops into the resident's Nuka-Cola and take the comic book while he's unconscious. I want this kid to know who has his comic book, so that every time he sees me, he cries a little inside, so we're gonna steal it at gunpoint, people.
Question 9.
Let's see.
You decide it would be fun to play a prank.
I decided it would be fun to play a prank on my father, because he didn't let me skip the stupid test. So what can I do? I can loosen the bolts in some pipe, and when the sink is turned on, the restroom will flood, put a firecracker in his toilet. That's awkward and probably not very pleasant if you have to sit on the toilet and that's going off. Break into the locked medicine cabinet and replace his high blood sugar pills with medication with sugar pills and manipulate the voltage on his razor so he'll get an electric shock next time he shaves, but mildly kill my father. Blood sugar. Here's the most annoying question that takes forever for him to get through. Important person involved 101.
He who shelters
me,
of the atomic wasteland,
loves me, probably has sex with various women in the vault. I'm just saying. Alright. Oh, damn. The overseer. Oh, man. One time I should do through all these questions with the same thing and pick different overseers and see what that does. So let's pick the first one.
Pencils down, people.
That's it. I'm done. Let me up.
I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, they're all
in the department. Funny joke. In the past class, that's fine. You can always be a janitor.
You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Okay. Taking that. I did not just steal. No, Professor.
Huh.
Ooh, I'm a tattoo artist. That's so funny. I do have a tattoo. Ooh, alright guys, I have like some amount of seconds. So I'm gonna leave it here. Like the video if you like it. Press the little thumbs up button. Leave a comment below if you want to talk with me or anyone else who's talking on the comments. And I will see you guys next time.